This is the site of the JAFB Wooster Brewery at the foot of Bell in Worcester.
I'm Paul Fryman, the brewer and owner of JAFB Wooster Brewery. So a typical brew day for me, I'll come in here and we're going to start with all this different malted barley we have here. So every batch is going to be between about 400 and 600 pounds. Where I'm going to mix up different varieties of barley and then crush it to a mill right now. And then there's a flex auger where the crushed malt barley and sometimes some wheat and rye can be transported up this white flex auger over. So the barley's been crushed. It's now sitting in our grist hopper, which is above me. At the same time, I've been heating water up. We'll get the water. It's in a hot liquor tank underneath the mash tun. I'm going to add that hot water to the grist or the barley that we crushed in the actual mash tun. There's an enzymatic conversion where the starches and carbohydrates in the barley are converted to fermentable sugars with that mixture of hot water at a given temperature. That conversion takes about an hour. I mix everything up by hand, so you're going to have 500 pounds of malt with another 1,000 pounds of water in the actual mash tun. And after it's done and nice mixed up, I hit my temperature, it converts. Then we want to recirculate or boil off, as the proper term, the wort. We create, it's now called wort. That's the actual term for the future beer, I guess we would say. So boil off that, we want to kind of clarify it. So every step of the process, we want to kind of eliminate solids. So recirculate it over top of itself. The husks of the grain that we crushed in the mill will create a filter, so we get a nice clear liquid. It's now pumped over into the kettle, so we'll start filling the kettle with wort as the grain stays behind. So then we'll take even hotter water, raise the temperature to about 170 degrees, and basically give the grain a shower and rinses all those sugars out. So it's kind of a balancing act. So we're filling up the kettle as we're eliminating the wort. Mash time. So we get about 300 gallons of wort, bring it to a boil. This is all heated with steam, and that's where we add the hops. And the hops have beta acids and amp acids and different oil content that kind of balances out the really sweetness of the wort with the nice bitterness and aroma of the hops. From there, we'll boil it for at least an hour, depending on how where I need to hit my gravities, and I take temperature readings throughout the process. After that's all done, we shut the heat off, we spin it, which is called whirlpool. Once again, getting solids to drop out of suspension, and then we're going to transfer it, rapidly cool the wort down into one of these fermenters. So today, I'm actually brewing into this second fermenter right here. So I'll have a bunch of hoses laid out and a pump, and we'll sanitize everything as I'm brewing, and then we'll transfer the wort right up into the fermenter there, which ready to go. And right before I do that, I pitch yeast, and that's why these are all cone-shaped. The yeast is a single-cell organism. It consumes all the sugars that we created in the mash, and its byproduct is CO2 and alcohol, and it creates beer. That process takes about 7 days, give or take, and then we need another 10 days or so to let it kind of condition, and then we cool it. So we have glycol chilling lines all above us. So the whole process for monitoring temperatures, every stage of the process. And after we chill it, and get it crashed out, drop all the yeast out, and then filter all the beers. And so that's the next step, which we're gonna go into the cooler right over here. So here we are in the cellar. We have six more tanks in here. These are our conditioning tanks or serving tanks. So the beer is filtered right into this room. Well, these tanks are purged of all the oxygen, and then we filter the beer right into here, and that's where we'll carbonate it as well. After that's done, we'll put it on tap. So these, this hose coming off the tank here is actually a draft line. So we have all the draft lines going right through the wall there and on tap through the wall. So direct draw right to the other side of the wall, and we have our finished product. So this is our finished product. They never need a tank. Redo the process over again. We'll keg the tank off. Kegs going next door. So we have 8 beers on tap in this room and 8 beers on tap in the other room behind. behind me, which is all just kegs. So this is our tasting room here in the brewery, and this is, as you can see, we can fit quite a lot of people in here, and everybody can come and enjoy their beer and have a good time, bring in food, and family get-togethers. So we typically have about 16 beers on tap, ranging in all kinds of different styles. We have about 5 to 8 that are typically always kind of our mainstays that are always on tap, and then we'll differentiate between Belgian and British-inspired, Belgian or German-inspired beers throughout the year, throughout the seasons, depending on the temperature. Colder weather, darker beers, typically warmer, we'll have a little bit lighter. And today I'm brewing the red ale, so I will pour one.